Valve has recently added a Valve Index support tag on Steam. This is awesome, but this tag does not make it clear whether the game has native Index controller support. The new controllers have unique finger tracking features that only work if a developer implements it in their game. So straight out of the box, there might not be a lot of games available that you can use with the Index controllers. At least, not without spending some time tweaking it using the Steam VR controller binding tool. In this video, I'll explain where you can find the games that do have Index controller support, and I'll explain what happens if you use the controllers in a game that does not support it. And lastly, I'll show you the Steam VR controller binding tool. So this video is for those that have ordered the Valve Index controllers, but even if you are on the fence of ordering one, then this video could be also useful to you. Subscribe if you haven't yet to join more VR adventures like this one. This video is coming up. Let's start with a brief introduction. The Valve Index controllers are the new controllers soon to be shipped by Valve. With these new controllers, Valve focuses on enabling natural input, high fidelity hand presence, and comfort in VR. With its 87 sensors, it can track hand position, finger position, motion, and even pressure, allowing you to grab objects by squeezing the controller or making hand gestures, like the peace sign. The most interesting design choice is that it has a strap that goes over your hand, allowing you to open your hands without dropping the controllers. This allows you to realistically drop and throw virtual objects. The Valve Index controllers can be ordered in a kit with the Valve Index VR headset or separately for $279 or €299. Just to be clear, the Valve Index and controllers can play any Steam VR compatible game straight out of the box. Developers do not need to change anything for it to work, but if a game does not natively support the Index controllers, the button mapping could be wrong. It's like using Revive on the HTC Vive to play Oculus Touch games. Fortunately, Valve is providing a rebinding tool that I will show later in this video, but let's talk about the games with native support for the Index controllers first. So, to have full Index controllers hand presence in a game, developers need to add these hand animations and interactions to their game, like these finger tracking hand animations that you can see here. How do you know which games have full Index controller support though? And where do you find these games? Right now, the Steam pages do not make this clear, so there is actually a list that our awesome community has made. This list can be found on Reddit, which I will link in our description. The games on this list are added based on developers specifically stating that they have implemented or are working on Index controller support. It even links the source of where it was found. However, I did notice that when developers say they support the Valve Index controllers, it does not mean that they have implemented the full package, like finger tracking animations or squeezing. For example, I tried PokerStars VR, and while it works with the Index controllers with the right button mapping, it does not have any of the extra features. Unfortunately, most of the games on this list are like this. Thankfully, there are some games I tried that do have full Index controller support, for example a Township Tale, Climby, Neos VR, and Moondust, of course. I have to say, when they do work, it is a really fun experience. I am guessing that developers are still working on full Index controller support, and more games will be added over time, so just be ready to have a little bit of patience. I also think that Steam will have a tag that shows this support eventually, at least I really hope so. While you're watching this video, please leave a like to show your support. So what about the games that do not have native support for the Valve Index controllers? I've noticed here that the game sometimes detects the Valve Index controllers as touch controllers, making some of the button bindings very awkward, like the A button of the touch controller will be mapped on the upper part of the joystick of the Index controllers. Or you are not able to use the grips of the Index controllers at all, instead the grip is mapped on the trigger button. Thankfully, Steam VR has an easy to use input binding tool. You can access it by right clicking Steam VR, then Devices, Configure Controller, Controller Binding. Here you can find the games you have installed, and if you click on one of those games, you are able to change the controller mapping. Let me quickly explain what you will see. Every game will have an index controller legacy default binding that it's set on. Now, just to make it clear, in some games this does work pretty well. If you click on edit, you see all the controller bindings here. I would not recommend replacing this binding though. If you want to create a new one, you have to click on create new binding. And here you can rebind every button. For example, if you want to change what the trackpad does, then click this edit icon and select what you want it to do. All the buttons you see here are from the original HTC Vive and Oculus Touch controllers. You will basically put whatever the button on your old controller did on this new button. Now, this might take some time to figure out. I find it the easiest to just go into the game and check what every button does. If one button is not intuitive, I will change it. Like I did that for Orbis VR here, most of the buttons were mapped quite well, except the trackpad and the thumbstick were both used for smooth locomotion. And as you can see here, the trackpad of the Index controllers only goes up and down now, so it's not really handy. So I turned it off except for the press. I put a teleportation binding on it so I can use the trackpad now for teleportation and the thumbstick for smooth locomotion. One tip here is that you do not need to turn off the game to change this. You can change the button mapping with the game on in the background. Just make sure you save it after you're done and you'll be able to use your new binding directly in the game. There are also community bindings as you can see here. These are bindings created by someone else and uploaded to the workshop, which is a great little feature and would save you a lot of time. I'm guessing that when the Index controllers start shipping everywhere, we'll see more and more of these community bindings. You can create one yourself too and share it with everyone. It would be really helpful. So yes, this is the current state of how you can use the Index controllers. I just wanted to make you aware that straight out of the box, there might not be a lot of games available with the full hand presence, including finger tracking and squeezing, and some games will not support the controllers at all straight away. For those to work, you will need to spend some time to do some tweaking as shown in this video. In the future, I hope to see more options in seeing which games support the controllers fully. It will be really awesome to see developers implementing the full Index controllers capabilities in the future games that they are making. I'm pretty sure that I'll be getting those games earlier than games without this support. What about you? Are you looking forward to giving this a try, or are you going to wait until more games get support? Let us know in the comments. Also, tonight we'll be live streaming a game with full Index controller support. It's a free game too, so if you have any questions or would like to know or see what it is like, join us tonight at 9 PM Central European Summertime. A special thanks goes to Art Armin for being our right-hand patron, and a special shout out goes to his Patreon page. Everyone, thank you so much for watching, and as always, VR on! Then this video could be also useful to you. Yeah. In the future, I hope to see more In the future, I hope to see more options in games. Blah blah blah.